This is a statement that I'm reading from Mr. Robert Grine, who's not able to be here today. My name is Robert Grine, and I lived in Tyonesta, Pennsylvania, with my wife, Dr. Joanne Grine, and with my mother, Mrs. Margaret Grine, when all of us became witnesses to an environmental crime. We were witnesses to the release of poisonous, explosive, and corrosive chemical materials into air and water. Federally licensed overpacked drums were torn apart by our neighbor in his backyard next door to our home. That neighbor, William Coombs, spilled the contents of the drums onto the ground and into wells and groundwater. The drums were owned by a corporation registered in Florida as Rotocast Plastic Products, Inc., and a DOT license number, Department of Transportation, E9775, was permanently marked on the body of each 85-gallon overpacked drum. There is no federally licensed disposal site for hazardous waste in the borough of Tyonesta. When we saw foaming liquid come out of our wet weather spring and burrowing animals such as groundhogs, moles, and mice lay dead in our yard, we hired a laboratory to take samples of the liquid. And we called the PADEP to report that we believed a disaster had taken place. The PADEP was very slow to respond when their agents did finally come to our home. They immediately told us that if we did not withdraw our complaint, they would see that we were blamed for the pollution event which had taken place and would frame a prosecution against us. The U.S. EPA's agents were no better. They claimed they did not see any DOT licensed overpacked drums at the Coombs site. Though in the presence of witnesses, their field agent walked to the Coombs property and put his hands in an overpacked drum, which stood there with 20 or 30 other drums in the open and in plain view. I do not have enough space here to tell you about all the things that we went through in federal court, and we went through a lot. In summary, the record was extensively corrupted by government agents, government lawyers suborned perjury from their clients, discovery of documents in the public domain and FOIA requests were unlawfully denied to us, and the district court judge told us that he lacked jurisdiction over exclusively federal environmental claims. Nothing was done by the government or its regulatory agencies to stop the illegal transport and disposal of highly toxic chemicals on land and into water supplies. Movement of the drums from the Coombs property to other locations took place without government interference for years. In the middle of our case in federal court, we found out that a grand jury had been convened. I, Robert Grine, was apparently the target of that grand jury investigation. Fortunately, the persons on the grand jury were not stupid enough to believe that I was the criminal transporter of all the hazmat drums and had dumped them on myself and on my family. No one was indicted. Years after the case was dismissed, I discovered on the internet that my property, the Grine property, had been designated in 1994 as a Superfund site. From 1995 through 2004, agents of the U.S. EPA were testifying that no dangerous chemicals were on my property and testifying that there was no health threat to me or to my family. At the same time, in complete secrecy and without notice to us or to the community, my property was designated as a Superfund site. The property, which was the actual source of the contamination, the Coombs property, was never identified or described as such by the U.S. government. There has never been, to this day, any remediation of the Coombs property or of my home ground.